Hello, I'm Marion Steiner. Together we will build a dynamic table with the dox42 worded in them. We'll work with an example order confirmation. In our case, this example is linked to a Microsoft Access database. However, you can also link Oracle, MySQL, or any other database to the document. We will use an existing template. As you can see, the rough structure of the document already exists. First of all, we change to the dox42 ribbon in Word and start by setting up a data map. This is where we define data fields, which we will later on insert into the template. In this data map, our first step is to configure the input parameter. This parameter enables us to generate the confirmation for the one specific order. Product as well as customer data, matching the order number we enter, will be retrieved from the Access database. Our next step is to link the table orders from Access to our document. By clicking on Connection, you can assemble the string for your database. In this example, I've already compiled the corresponding connection string. With the help of the Query Designer, we now link the data fields. In order to select all data for the one order we select with the input parameter, we assign the order number from our parameter to the order number of the Access database. Following this, we select all remaining product data and the customer ID from the table order. We now have the possibility to see a preview of our query. We'll try that out for one example order by entering the order number. We can see that all ordered products are listed. After we save the data map and permanently link it to our document, we now insert the missing information into our document. Clicking on Insert Data Field opens the Data Field Explorer on the right-hand side of our Word window. All connections to our Access database we've just set up are shown here and can be easily inserted right away. Let's start with the product image. Therefore, we just select and drag the field into the document. We set the type on image and specify the width of the picture. Since all product images are stored in the folder Pictures in the same directory as our document, we use the docpath command. In the same manner, we insert the remaining product information either by drag and drop or just double clicking. At the same time, we define the data field type, such as, for example, adding the dollar sign and two decimals, the abbreviation for pieces, or the percent symbol. In order for the table to expand automatically, meaning adding a new row for each product, we select the according row, click on Automate Range, and have the row repeated for the data source orders. This is the point where we run our first test. Let's generate the document for the order number 56. As we can see, all products, including their images, are already listed in the table. We're only missing the total sums and customer data in our confirmation. Returning to the template, I've already set up the data sources Customers and total sums, in the same way as the data source orders before. In order to calculate the product sum, including value-added tax, we make use of the function dynamic field in the data map designer. You can even use data fields in your formulas here. Let's finish off our document by inserting customer data, the order number, the salutation, the date of order, and the grand totals in the corresponding format. The only thing left to do is to generate the document once again. Again, let's use the order number 56. What we get is an order confirmation including all product and customer data. Thank you for your attention, and remember to check out our website www.dox42.com.